record this before I forget. So we'd love to hear from you as far as your best tips for attracting and inviting. Like, where do you find your new working coaches? What do you think's most important about it? And then how do you get them started? Right. Are you guys, is everyone ready?
Okay.
We're getting pens.
We're getting pens.
Cool. Well, I did put together a little presentation.
Oh my gosh, you're so cool.
Look at my presentation instead of sharing it with you guys. I'd much rather see your face than words. So if I stop looking at the camera, it's just because I'm glancing at what I have put together. So you just let me know when we're ready.
I think we're ready.
Okay, let me do one thing really quick. Sorry, my daughter came in and got a snack, and the fridge was like beeping at me, and my husband took the boys dirt bike riding today, so it's us. I'm like, eat whatever you want.
That's perfect. Everyone here is a mom too, so, and we've got moms of little ones and moms of school age kids, teenagers. So we've got the spectrum.
Awesome. Want me to just start?
Yeah, sorry.
Go for it.
Shoot, go for it.
Okay, awesome. Good morning, you guys. I am so grateful that Jess asked me to connect with you guys this morning. And I'll be perfectly honest with you. I've been in the business for 6.5 years, and I still at times doubt my ability. Like, I'm like, why would she want me to talk to them, right? And so I had to really just sit down and think of what I wanted to share with you guys specifically on this topic. If you don't know my story, I'm going to give you a high-level overview. So like I said, I've been a coach for 6.5 years. February will be 7 years, which just seems unreal to me because my expectation coming into this business was to literally get a 25% discount for the 1 month, cancel my shakes. Like, I saw my coach is Mindy Horde, but she is under Becky Brosse and Christina Delgado. And so I saw those three doing all these things, and I just didn't think that it was for me, right? I worked a full-time job. I was in corporate America. I had 14 people who reported directly to me. And what I was doing in life felt like what I was supposed to do because I was serving people. And I can now see that my whole life, people have been my ministry. And I've only known the Lord for about 3.5 years, but I'm going to talk about him and I'm going to glorify him because where I am today in this business is because of the things that he's done for me in my life. So I watched silently for 13 months before I did anything. I watched them walk away from their full-time jobs. I watched them come home to their children. I watched them get in the best shape of their lives. I watched them go on these trips. And one day, I think it was right after Christina got out of the 21-day fix test group, which is funny because she's in the 9 weeks filming video right now, but she shared her results and she had lost 12 pounds and like 12 inches. And I was like, whoa, if that chick lost 12 pounds, like, she doesn't even have 12 pounds to lose. Like, what could I do? And hold on. What's that? Nope. Go put that back. Please don't. Hey, listen to mom. You can't put that on your face. Okay. Nope. Thank you. Love you. She comes out with a black mascara. Can we do my makeup? Let me know if it breaks up at all also. So I just was like, if she can do it, why not me? Right. And so I decided to reach out to Mindy and I got on a like 40-minute conversation with her while I was at my office. And I remember thinking, what the heck is wrong with me? Why am I sobbing to this stranger? Like, she doesn't know me. I don't know her. Like, how, why am I telling her like all my life story? But something just felt right. And so I told her I was going to sign up. 2 weeks later, I did. I kept dragging my feet because, you guys, $140 felt like a huge investment to me. It did. But when I looked back at my bank account, I saw that I was had zero issue stopping for a bottle of wine on the way home after a long day. I saw that I had zero issue dropping $100 for drinks out with my husband. I had zero issue going to Kohl's on my lunch break and buying a shirt or a pair of shoes. I had zero issue going to Rayleigh's, which was right next to my work, and getting Red Bulls or Monster drinks and those little Jenny Craig like frozen meals or any type of low fat, because that was what I thought was going to get me the results that I needed. And so when I added all that up and it was way more than $140, again, I thought, okay, why not me? I can totally do this. I'm going to stick this out for 100 or for 21 days for $140. Worst case scenario is I send it back. I literally tried everything under the sun. I had done like the It Works skinny wraps. I had tried every diet pill that GNC had to offer. You name it, I did it. Like, I was a queen of quick fixes because I needed to feel better in myself. I grew up with a very low self-esteem. I came from a very traumatic and toxic childhood, which also developed into very toxic and traumatic behaviors as a young adult. I didn't have any self-worth, but I never had anyone in my life modeling that. And so I didn't know what health really was, right? I knew what society said it was, and I was nothing like that. And so I was basically hanging on to anything that was going to make me feel better about myself. And for so long, I found that in a bottle of wine or toxic friendships. And all of a sudden, I was in this community filled with sisterhood that people were empowering me and they were encouraging me. And people who did not know me were cheering me on. And that was something that was so different, because in corporate America, like, I'm sure some of you guys know, you've probably worked in positions like that where, especially if you're in a leadership role, crap kind of rolls downhill and you have to deliver the bad news, the good news, and you become the bad guy, right? And personal development was forced in corporate America, but it wasn't like we do. And so that was like a whole different world to me. I remember reading You Are a Badass on Audible on my way to and from work every single morning. Anytime I could get on the national wake-up call live, I would. I remember listening to, I think it was Brigida Langford, and she was talking about how she had these mental health issues and that she had actually spent time in a mental health ward, and that her and her husband at one time had like paid for their family's groceries with food stamps. And to me, that made this real. That made this didn't look like some big unicorns out there that was unsustainable to me. This felt like real life to me. I watched Amy Silverman at my first super weekend talking about how she purchased her first luxury vehicle, and it was like a Chevy Silverado. She wasn't talking about a Mercedes or a Lexus, or it was real people doing life and helping people and serving people. And that's what I feel like I've always been called to do. And so I'm going to get to my presentation, but I just want you to understand that if we can, so can you. And we get the same interruptions with our kids, right? We face the same battles. Some people might have fancier filters or get different results than you or build their business quicker. But if somebody else has done what you want to do, you can do it. And if somebody hasn't done what you want to do yet, go and blaze that trail, because people are depending on you to build a business and help them do the same, okay? So today we're going to be talking about the power of your story and how I've built this business by sharing my story to connect with others. My first tip for you guys, though, today, and I hope that you write this down, is team culture. And you guys know, because you're at a leadership retreat right now, that team culture is everything, right? I've never had a lack of friends, but what I told you was I didn't have anyone who was lifting me up, who was praying for me, who was encouraging me, who was shouting from the rooftops the things that I had done behind closed doors, right? I didn't. I had people who wanted to share a bottle of wine or talk about how stressed out they were about their jobs or how crappy their husband was being or all those things, right? So create the culture that you want. And with that becomes vision. maybe you're thinking, I only have 12 people on my team right now, but I really want to get to 12,000 or 1,200, right? So you have to create what that vision looks like. When you're hosting your leadership retreat next year, how many people do you want to have there with you? What's the atmosphere that you want to have? What's the team swag that everyone's going to be wearing? What are the pictures you guys are going to take? What is the food that you're going to have? Because when you have a vision, you can communicate that to other people, and people are going to want to join your train, right? I tell my team all the time, if you get off the train, that's perfectly okay. You can take your bags and you can sit at the bus stop. We will always come back around for you. That doesn't mean I'm not going to love on you. I'm not going to champion for you. I'm not going to be here for you, but I can't get off at that stop with you. Like, there's more lives to change. There's more things that my family is working towards. My train is constantly moving, and you're welcome to get on and off at any point, and know that you always have a seat on our train, but we got to keep going, right? That's part of my vision, and that's a part of my team culture. I want you to be a part of it, but I can't drag you. That's exhausting. Okay, so let me get into here so I can pull up my presentation.
So good.
What?
I said so good. We were just talking about
this. Oh.
So it's
okay. So recruiting with the power of your story. So the second thing I want you guys to think about is, who are you looking for and why? If you don't know who you're talking to, you're basically talking to everyone, right? And I don't know about you guys, but I've tried that and it hasn't worked. When you're speaking to the masses, it's like white noise. So I want you to get very clear, and I'm gonna set a timer on my phone, and we're gonna take the next 60 seconds, and I want you to write down as many things that are qualities or characteristics or hobbies or whatever that would describe you in your life, or where you were before Beachbody. So working mom, busy mom, sports mom, wife, single mom, moms who love wine. Like, I don't care what it is. I'm gonna set my timer and we are gonna go and do that in just a second. And I want you to
you are before Beachbody, right?
Yep. Okay. And who, like, what do you like to do now?
So, okay.
Just qualities and other, and yourself, that you would love to work with people.
So the positive things we want to.
Oh. Yeah, all the positive things.
All positive. Let me be in control.
Pain and control is
still being, yeah. Bring it in.
Down some characteristics of things that you admire about yourself, but also things that you want for your future, right? The things that you wrote down are the things that you're going to go out and speak to on social media. So many times we get caught up in, I don't know what to post. But when you are very clear and specific on who you want to talk to, you can go talk to yourself, right? And so half the time when I'm creating messages, I'm talking to myself. I'm talking to the old me. I'm talking to the me that needed a way out of her 9-to-5. The one who was sick and tired of dropping her babies off at daycare when they were sick, only to tell the babysitter, hey, call me if a fever spikes, I'll try to get out of work, right? That was like gut-wrenching to me. I'm talking to the me who was trying to find herself in a bottle of wine or put her self-worth in, you know, the value of, or the size of her clothes or the value of her possessions. Because just like me, a lot of people, they feel like they have a solution already. They're doing Jenny Craig, they're doing Weight Watchers, they're doing Orange Theory, they have a gym membership, they do CrossFit, but what they don't have is purpose, right? So you have to figure out what their pain points are and go speak to that. So that's my second bullet point, is you have to know who you're talking to and then go out and create messages that are gonna connect with them, okay? The other thing with that, guys, is don't expect that every time you put a message out, that everyone's gonna flock to it or that everyone's going to understand it. I want you to share the ugly parts of your life. I want you to share the discomfort. I want you to share the moments where you find yourself in the pantry or the laundry room or the front seat of your car where you are literally struggling to figure out how you're going to make it through or how you were going to make it through, and go tell people how they can, because you've been there and you've survived that. People want to know that you're a real human. When I'm looking for the people on my team, I don't want a cookie cutter coach. I don't want somebody who has a freaking perfect life, because guess what? Life is hard and is going to knock you freaking down, and you have to learn how to get back up every single time, because we were created with purpose, and I have no doubt in my mind why we are all together to get today on a Saturday morning at 10:15 in the morning talking about how we can serve other people and get to the right people and then bring them on and teach them how to build this, right? My thing with my team is I do, we do, you do. And I'll get to that later on in the presentation. But it's so important for them to know who you are, because when you can create that emotion within them, something's going to shift. They're going to start trusting you. They're going to start coming to your page. There was a reason why I watched my coach for 13 months. She made me feel like I was a part of something before I even was a part of something, right? There was a reason why I started watching Becky and Christina, because they had this culture that I was craving, and I didn't even know I wanted that or that it existed out there. I was 100% comfortable working for someone else for the rest of my life because I thought that's what I was supposed to do. I thought that earning money and holding a quote unquote powerful position was how I was going to help my family. When in the whole time, guys, I was so disconnected from my family. I was out there helping my team at work, killing myself for them, picking up the phone on my days off, going and covering people who were sick, but I didn't even have my own family's back, right? And so that's the story I'm telling when I talk to people, because I want people to understand there is another way, there is a solution. And even if you never walk away from that, you can have more. Maybe it's not living paycheck to paycheck anymore. Maybe it's not depending on your paid family leave so that you can be home with your kids. That was a really scary thing for me. 3 months into my journey, I got pregnant with my daughter. I had a choice at that time of whether I could pull back from this business. I was barely a diamond. I think I just hit diamond. Or whether I was going to go all in. And I tell you that maternity leave gave me a taste of that freedom that I had with my boys. And I was like, oh yeah, no, nope, we're totally going to do this. We are going all in. And I did send my daughter back to daycare for 3 months. And then I think I made like $750 a week. And I was like, okay, I'm going to figure this out, but I need to be home. So I probably left my job prematurely, for sure, which I would not encourage my team to do that. And I told my husband, give me 2 years, and if it doesn't work, I'll go back to work. In 2 years, I tripled my income. An income that I didn't even know existed. Right? Okay, let me get back to this because I literally can get on the preaching box. Okay. So when you are finding who are you looking for and why, I want you to look for brands that you love, products that you use, if it's baby products, mom products, cleaning products, specific linens that you purchase, specific foods that you shop, specific restaurants that you frequent. What are the accounts that you're currently following? And I'm not talking about Beachbody coaches. I'm talking about, there's this one influencer. You guys, literally, look at this water jug that I have. Because I follow this fashion influencer, who got this water bottle. And now I have this $20 gigantic Amazon water bottle that I set a goal every single day. Actually, I'm doing 75 hard right now, but that I drink every single day because I was influenced by her. Guess how many other people are influenced by her? Like 12 million. So guess what? I'm going to go check out the people who are following her and are commenting on her posts and engaging with the things that she does, because they might be my people too, right? We have similar interests. And so that's the same thing for the restaurants that I frequent, or the brands that I like, or the products that I do, or the groups that I'm a part of. Think about where you shop. What's your favorite time of year? Right now, I love the weather. I love all things pumpkin. I love pumpkin spice. I love that I can sometimes wear a sweater at noon and not die. Today I would die. But, you know, like, it's fall. I love fall. I also love summer. Rain, not so much. So I'm going to go find the other people who love all those things that I do as well, okay? What are the things that you're really freaking good at? Are you good at organizing? Hashtag not me. Are you good? Are you a runner? Are you good at doing hair? Are you good at redecorating your house for the holidays? Like, think about the things that you're really good at, and then go and create that content for people. And then go and search those hashtags of the people that like those sorts of things as well, because you'll find your people in those moments. Get very specific. And then I want you to think about, who am I most excited to work with? Because we all know, and if you don't, maybe you'll find this in the future, Lord forgive me for this, but we have those people on our teams that we see their name come across our inbox and we're like, oh my gosh, if you would just check the FAQ, like, please. So who do you want to work with? Who do you want to spend an entire weekend with? Who do you want at your retreat, right? Think about the people and their personalities that light you up, and go out and find those people. Talk to those people in your post. The other thing is, I want you, and I think I kind of covered this, but it, post and speak to other people's pain points. If somebody's giving you an objection and they're like, I just don't have any time, you know, I'm literally feel like I'm drowning in virtual schooling. I get up at 4:30 in the morning just to get the house in order and make lunches and try to just have some time to myself. Girl, same. We all get the same 24 hours, right? So go and talk to other people's pain points, because I promise you, they're not the only ones that have it, and they're not the only ones who are watching your stuff. Okay. Next point, share the heck out of this opportunity. Okay, so what do I mean by that? Every single day, you should have some sort of call to action within your Instagram stories. So if you go to my stories from yesterday, I have a call to action for a clean eating group that I'm going to start. I haven't done a free clean eating group, and I can't even remember the last time I did one. But I'm going to do one on Monday. Know why? Because they work. And it's been a while since I did it. And sometimes we forget the things that work that are so freaking simple. And it's the end of the month. We had five weeks this month. And next month we're going to have 5 weeks again. And so that's kind of like my limbo month. So it's a half a week, so I can help my team lock in Success Club. I can start planting seeds for the new people coming in, and then hopefully lock in Success Club for October by the end of next week. And I plan to do that from my free group, okay? So you'll see that call to action. I've already spoke about speaking on this today. So I show people that I work, right? When you do your workout clips, invite people to join your accountability groups. It can be something as simple as 35 minutes pouring in myself. Why not you? I mean, that's pretty simple, but are you ready to work out with us? Right? I had something the other day. It was me and my girlfriend, and a girl messaged me and she was like, are you guys still evacuated from the fires? Because we were evacuated for 10 days. And I was like, oh girl, no, I'm just getting some sanity, like working out with my girlfriend over here, having an adult conversation. Right? And so I went back and put that in my stories so that I could make it very clear to people why I'm working out, that I have a community that I get to do this with. And that even in the thick of coronavirus, / supposed to be quarantine, lockdown, virtual distance learning, all sports are canceled, making 7,000 snacks a day, I still take time for myself too. Okay? And I'm empowering others to do the exact same thing. Other things is call to action posts at least 3 times a week. So maybe that's, and I would be intentional with planning these. So maybe that's Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday night. You have a call to action post where you are getting very intentional on saying, hey, I have this incredible opportunity and I want you to do it. Here's why. I'm on this incredible leadership retreat that I earned for the work that I get to do. Here's the work that I do, right? And give them, you don't have to go word vomit and tell everything, but again, figure out something emotional to tie into because that's what's going to help other people. The other thing is maybe on Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday, you're gonna have a fitness call to action post. Right? Or you can say, you know, the first half of my month is going to be specifically coaching. The second half of my month is going to be specifically boot camp stuff, whatever you want to do, but absolutely make sure you're doing that. I literally love Facebook. I know people say it's for old people. I will take that title. I love it. It's always been my bread and butter. It just feels like home to me. Instagram kind of feels like somewhere I'm visiting and I like, I'm like, hey, like, don't know what I'm doing here, but we're figuring it out together. But I'm still gonna post. So literally what I figured out is anything I post on Facebook, I just transfer it, put my nice preset, and I post on Instagram. Unless it's like a novel, because I hate that. You can't even freaking post everything on Instagram. And then when I don't know what to say, I give myself some quiet time and I just ask the Lord, like, what do you want me to say today? Like, what do you want me to communicate today, right? So those calls to action. And now that I'm talking openly about my faith, I find people who have strong faith. It's so funny. When I got sober, I didn't know anyone sober. Now my like feed is like people who want to get sober, people who are sober curious, people who have years under their belt. Same thing with my faith. As soon as I started talking about my foundation and where my strength comes from and that I haven't gotten this far on my own, guess what? My team is following the Lord. I have people who did not, same as me, did not grow up in church or walked away from the church because they did grow in. And now it's like they're talking about it as well. Okay. So talk about the things that are important to you. I would also do public events on Facebook. So even if you're not going to run anything in there, this is a nice way for people to see that you actually do stuff. Right? So like wineries all around me, they're constantly posting events. Hashtag same. Me too. I'm going to do that too. So even though I'm not going to post my stuff for my free group, I'm going to have that event. And guess what? Anyone who's on my friends list is going to see, oh, Melissa has this event coming up. Guess what? Yesterday I posted it and within a couple minutes I had 2 RSVPs. I didn't invite them. They saw it and RSVP'd themselves. Okay. And then the other thing is make sure that you're doing sneak peeks. So I do 2 a month. One of them is a team-wide one, which it comes within the leaders of Diesel Nation. And we kind of alternate what that looks like. And it's always Christina and Becky and then another leader. And then I also do one by myself for my team. And I follow suit and I grab 2 people from my team. One of us is talking about the benefits of being a part of our team and doing this business. Another person is maybe not as seasoned as us and they're sharing their story and their testimony of, you know, how being a part of our team has helped them physically, financially, emotionally, and talking about that. And then the final person is wrapping it up and talking about how you can get started with us. Okay. Talk about coaching. Go ahead. Yeah,
really quick, on your guys' sneak peeks, do you do Zoom calls or what's your platform for that?
Yeah, Zoom. Zoom and then record it to YouTube.
Okay.
Yep. And then talk about the coaching activities daily, weave it into your life so people know that they can do this too, right? Making my kids a snack. Now I'm going to send a bunch of voice memos, right? or waking up at 4:30 in the morning, getting my devotional, my gratitude journaling, and then I'm going to hop on a power hour with my team because we're all busy moms and we need to get this done before the kids are up. Do I want to get up at 4:30? Nope, sure don't. But guess what? I'm making these sacrifices because I know the alternative. I also didn't want to drop my kids off at daycare and spend my days working for somebody else's dream when I knew that there was something available to build for myself, right? And I use that language. And I've gotten very bold and intentional about who I'm looking for, why I'm doing this, and why I think that other people could be a part of this as well. And so using that bold language, it won't be everyone's cup of tea, but guess what? You'll find your people. You'll find the people who do want this. Okay. Next thing is tell people where you're going and invite them to come with you. Help them create the belief that you have, right? So maybe you don't have that $1,000 week yet, but talk to them about what happens when you do. Maybe you don't have your dream home yet, but take them on a journey of what that looks like and what you're doing to get there. Maybe you're not a 15-star diamond yet, but talk to them about why that's important, right? I talk to my team all the time that it's important for me to pave the way so that you know what's possible, right? You guys being at this retreat right now is painting a picture and planting seeds for your teens to be a part of this later. I guarantee you there's so much FOMO going on. There are so many people who are like, I can't wait till I'm a part of something like that. And you get to create that brick by brick, stone by stone. It does not happen overnight. You guys understand that because you're the ones in the trenches. You're the ones that are showing up every single day to do this. Okay. So make sure that people understand that they can do this too. I tell my team, there's nothing special about me. My secret sauce is consistency. When there's fires, I show up. When my kids are sick, they show up. When coronavirus struck, still showed up. When I decided to get sober, still showed up. When I was in excruciating, crippling pain with my rheumatoid arthritis, I still freaking show up. When I go on trips, I still show up. When it's the holidays, I still show up. All of the things, you guys, you have to make sure that people understand that life is going to happen, but you have to just keep going. People's sales are going to get freaking knocked out of them. Life is going to happen. People are going to get diagnosed with terminal diseases. Deaths are going to happen. People are going to move, like all the things. But I ask myself every single day, would I call into work if I was still working for someone else? Or if I had invested $500,000 into my own brick and mortar, if my kid had a bad night's sleep? No. Would I take a month off so I could figure things out because somebody told me no? Nope, I'd still show up and I'd figure out how to keep doing it. So you have to show people what's possible and walk them through those storms. Walk hand in hand with them. Let them know that they're not alone with it. Help them get rerouted in personal development. Help them pick a program and get some results. Because as we know, 2020 has shown us the only thing that is going to pass is time. And you're either going to take the opportunity and utilize it for what it is, or you're going to lay down and have a pity party. And for me, that's not possible. I'm not going to do that. I have too many people that are counting on me. Okay. Next thing is, I just put this quote up and it says, in a world of look at me girls, be a come with me girl. Mm-hmm. We want people to join us. We want people to understand that we are the nice ones. How many of you, and I didn't grow up this way, I had tons of girlfriends, but I talk to people all the time who are like, I just wasn't a girl's girl. Girls were mean, girls were catty. I've been hurt by friendships. Girl, I've been hurt by friendships too. I was just having a conversation yesterday that literally a memory popped up and it reminded me of a friendship that I like mourned the loss of that friendship. But I look today and I'm like, I don't have any ill feelings towards this person. I love her family. I would champion for them, but we're different. Just like I said at the beginning, I didn't have bad friends, but I also didn't have people who were rooting for me the way that we do in this community, right? Jess and I don't benefit anything from one another except for the fact that we get to grow together, we get to see each other at events, we get to clap for each other when we win. We want other people to know that's possible for them too. That grown adults just don't sit around and talk about all the awful things in their life and gossip about other moms at pickup line, that they are actually encouraging one another and saying, hey, I did this, come do it with me, it's really cool. And I have some awesome friends that I think you'd really love. And then you bring your awesome friends on too, and let's just do this, right? I think that's so important. And I already kind of covered this, but with my team, how I get them started right is I do, we do, you do. So I do have some specific systems that come into play, and I can send these to Jess and she can share them with you guys if you're interested. But everyone that gets started on my team, they have a new coach email. And in that email, you guys, it's so simple, but it looks pretty. And I paid someone to do it, and it didn't cost me $1 million. So I would highly encourage you, if that's something that's intimidating you, is like putting a system into place and having it look nice, outsource. Outsource that, because that was one of the biggest things that I was like, ooh, I just don't know if I can afford to do that. Because I was thinking it was like $500-$600 to like work with a designer. Nope. I have a guy who I've been working with for 2 years now. He's been the best investment. All my graphics are pretty now. It doesn't take me hours on Canva, which is not something I love. I don't love to make graphics. If you do, keep doing that. But then turn it into a side hustle and help your team do it and charge them $10. Just saying. But I don't enjoy doing that. And so I now outsource that. And so what's in my new coach email? It's welcome. They know a little bit about me. They know a little bit about our team. And then I'm going through and I'm giving them everything that they can find on the champions page, everything that they can find in the back office. But all it is in one nice place, and it's just hyperlinks. And I have a couple pictures of my team. There's also a link for them to set their first goals, how to get into our team page. We also have a new coach academy, which they could get through it, you know, into a weekend, or they could do it in 2 months. It's just completely up to them. And then I have another single page PDF that literally has all the getting start righted videos. You know how there's like those 5 videos that Beachbody sends to them? Well, I have that plus whatever videos. I think it's like Keisha and Moira and whoever else Kim asked. It's like a PDF and they get it. And it's simple. And all they do is that. And once they're done with that, then they message me and say, okay, what do I do next? And then I say, all right, so I want you to make a list of 5 people you want to do this with. That's it. 5 people. All of us know 5 people. And whether that's your husband, your mom, your sister, your best friend, the girl that you did spin class with forever, I don't care. Let's go find 5 people to link arms with and bring them on to do this with us. So not only is that number one, helping them make their success, their investment back, they're going to hit success club. And they are going to have that confidence, because now they've hit their first milestone in the business, because hopefully we're going to get them signed on as coaches, or they've hit Success Club for the first time and Beachbody's now going to reward them with a super cute tank. And I'm going to send them a new shaker cup sticker for their shaker cup so they can join in on energized dance parties or whatever they want, right? So we're helping them get those first wins and getting them immediate results for financial to make back their investment. And then they see how easy it is. And we just say, go do that again and do it again, right? So focus on helping 5 people within your first month. Does everybody do that? Nope, they don't. But we're setting that foundation so that they know it's possible. And now that Beachbody gives us 6 months to have success starters, it might be the next month that they do that, right? So the other thing is making sure that they understand how important it is to stick to a program, utilize the nutrition, and get results. Again, all we're doing, I do, we do, you do. They don't have to go out and create their own challenge group right away. I have an amazing group with content that's in there. Again, I outsource that content as well, or you can go into the back office and do that. The paperwork part of the business isn't my jam. The people are. So you have to figure out what lights you up and what gets you freaking really excited. Because if Jessica said, hey, Melissa, can you put together a 5-page PDF that I can share with my team at the retreat? I'd have been like, yeah, that sucks, but I'll do it. But instead she was like, hey, can you jump on a Zoom with us at 10 a.m.? I was like, yep, totally my jam. Can I just come there actually? Like, that's, people are my thing, right? And so making it very clear of how easy this is, uncomplicate it for them. Don't overwhelm them with all the stuff. So the reason, let me tell you why I made that PDF. I should back up for a second. I'm putting them in my team page. They're getting emails from Beachbody. They're going into our accountability group or challenge group that's going on. And so they go from having 6 notifications to having 60 in an hour. That's overwhelming. So I don't want to put them into the champions page until they're ready. So that new coach unit is amazing, but you got to be in there. So I was like, nope, I'm not putting my new coaches in there because I don't want them to get lost or overwhelmed or stressed out, because when people get lost, overwhelmed, and stressed out, they want to quit. I'm just going to have this made into a PDF. So that's why I did that. Again, I'll send this to you guys if you guys want it. You can see it. You can. Okay, I'll totally send it. It just makes it easier for me.
Hey, Melissa.
Yeah.
On your new Coach Academy, where do you host that?
So we have a Diesel Nation one, and it's just like an off website that they created. And for a long time I ran my own, where I would do like a 15-day new coach, and it would be in a group, and I would do that. I also, let me forget to talk about pods. I also tried the pod thing, but I felt like with so many people, like say I get 5 new coaches in a month, and then I'm putting them in there, and then everyone has questions, they have comments. Then they're like scrolling back, like, where was that assignment? Why recreate the wheel when it's already there for you? Yeah. Right? And honestly, they could get everything they need for that new Coach Academy in that information I sent them in that PDF, instead of if they don't want to go and do the Diesel Nation Academy. I do use pods though, you guys, and that has been gold, especially for my up and coming coaches and leaders. And so what that looks like is, say I have, you know, 10 new people who joined me in the month of September. Everyone who's joined me, whether they are a coach or they are here I am stuttering, or they are a new client, they're going to get added into the same pod. Why? Because they all got started in the month of September. So now they feel comfortable that they're working with other people. And if you even have one person who is like, has the gift of gab like me and can just go out and be open and cheer people on, that's going to make other people feel included. It's also a good way for me just to communicate and just say, hey, I see you haven't showed up in a couple days. How are you? Right? I'll take that out of the group. But it's a way for me. I do have a BOD group as well. I'll just be 100% transparent and just say it's not my favorite place. It feels very impersonal to me. And so they do have the option to request group access into the BOD group, where there's content shared continuously. But the pods really are my sweet spot. And then
where do you run those? Like,
is in your pod?
Thursday?
Say it again.
Is like your challenge group considered your pod then? Kind
of? No. So I have a challenge group too. So like right now I have the burn crew for, most people are doing MBF over and over again, MBFA. But I also have a regular, like lifetime group, and that's called the Soul Studio, and everyone gets added into that, and that has daily content. But my pods are, I have a new coach pod, new challenger pod, and then I have like a rising leaders pod. And then I have a pod called We Are a Superstar Team, because eventually that's the goal, right? So that's just my personally sponsored coaches. Oh, I also have a pod called The Work Squad, and that is anyone in my downline who's doing something in the business. When you get on the board with Success Club, when you hit Emerald and you want to get on Power Hours, all the things, that's where they're going. And the new coach pod, that's just going to be like each day I can share different assignments, like, hey, today's challenge is to go out and make a new coach post. Today's challenge is to go out and invite 10 people that are not in your warm market. Today's challenge is to go out and find 30 new people to follow on Instagram. So that's what that looks like.
Gotcha. Real quick, Melissa, Are you running those pods in a text, in a Facebook Messenger? What is your pod?
Facebook Messenger.
So I have a question about the pods of the Facebook Messenger, because I, and this is probably like just different coaches, different, you know, things.
Yeah.
I hate when people add me to Facebook group message pods.
Noted.
No, I see it so bad. But like, so I, and it might be just because I'm thinking of the one I'm thinking about is Zaya. I don't know if you've heard of it, but Zaya Active. I rep it for the discount only. And I have three Facebook message pods about all the things, and I don't like it. I muted them immediately because it was annoying. So I what I'm trying to get at with you, because it sounds, I get what you're saying, the body group's feeling impersonal, and that's why I've done a Marco Polo, but then not everybody wants their face out there. So, like, do you feel like that thread is, like, constantly going, or do you feel like it's not that bad? That's where I wonder if people will start getting like, I don't even want to check in there because, well, no.
Great question. Okay, so if it's important team information, it goes directly into my team page. So it's not like new announcements or things like that. And the only people that are in like the work squad or superstar team pods are people that want to be there.
Mm-hmm. What about Challenger pod was more what I was thinking, that one.
Okay, so Challenger pod, I set the expectation that this is going to be the easiest way for me to communicate with you guys that all came in together. I also want you to get to know one another. And if people are quiet, I've had people reach out to me and like, hey, just a heads up, I'm going to dip out of that group. It's just not for me. And I totally will respect that. Absolutely. Okay. So it's not for everyone. But I would say out of, you know, 30 people, maybe two it's not for. I just feel like we're able to really build relationships within there. And so like in my work squad or my, we are, so the work squad is not just my personally sponsored coaches. That's why I have the superstar pod as well. That's a lot of the same information, because that's where I'm sharing like, hey, we're jumping on a power hour, or don't forget team call. Or if somebody's like, hey, I just had somebody say that they're interested, I'm not really sure how to respond to it, here's part of the objection, what would you say? Right? So it's mostly people that want to be in it. With my Challenger pod, it's a different pod every month. So it's not like it's something that goes on forever. Like I will clear those people out, like remove them from the group, or create a September pod, an October pod.
Do you like, so for October, let's say you started a pod, because what I'm thinking in my mind, maybe that's good for like the first month, and then when we're done with that first month, set that expectation that then I'll put you to my bod groups. Because I have my active bod group, but I do like the ability to build that relationship in that first month. Do you do that?
Yes. So they always have the option to add themselves directly into the group right away. But I always set the tone that, hey, this is the easiest way. I feel like the first 30 days is really critical, because that's where you're going to be getting your results. And that's where you can like know you have contact to me at all times, but I can kind of blanket answer questions. Like if somebody's like, how much water should I be drinking in a day? Instead of having to answer that five different times for new people, I'm going to say, number one, refer to your book, but number two, it's half your body weight in ounces, right? Or somebody, why I really love these is like, especially with new people, people at the end of the first week are like, oh my gosh, I'm down 5 pounds, which then inspires and motivates and encourages everyone else. And in that pod, I'm looking for my new coaches, if they didn't sign as a coach. Right? I'm looking for the people who are showing up consistently. I'm looking for the people who are cheering on other people. And then I'm going to send them a message. I'm going to say, hey, Viv, I've been watching you. Number one, you're freaking crushing it and you look amazing. I can't imagine how good you feel. Number two, you're like a natural leader. I think you really should join our team, right? That's a message I just sent recently. And the girl messaged me yesterday and she's like, all right, coach, put me in. What do I need to do? I haven't believed that I could do this. But if you can do it, so can I. right? So not only is she now starting to use language I use, because those are things I say, but the increase of confidence because I planted the seed in public. I'm publicly in those pods, encouraging them, shouting them out, recognizing them, championing for them. It's not something where if it's just a one-on-one conversation that everyone else is going to see. Also, what happens is other people start seeing those people as leaders. Then you're not the only one who's answering all those questions. Then you're not the only one who, you know, is the one who can give that feedback. And you're fostering and you're cultivating that team culture for your clients that will then become your team. So that once they become a part of the team, they just know how it is. I'm going to give you an example. I have a girl, Kimberly. She was with one of my coaches who was a two-star diamond and decided that she was going to go and sell ketones a few years ago. And so I inherited all of her people, obviously. And actually, it's crazy because like four of them became diamonds on my team. Wow. It's just crazy. Like you pour into people, you love on people, you show them what's possible and they grow. Kind of like plants. but Kimberly just came back to me or just came back to our team in April. She would watch all my stories, all the things. And I finally was like, hey girl, like you keep watching, like, are you ready to come back? And she was like, I am. I had a baby. I need to transform. Like homegirl is down 52 pounds. Okay. 52 pounds since she came back. She just signed her eighth coach. Her goal is to be diamond by October 1st, which is a goal she didn't even know she had. Her dad just died yesterday too, unexpectedly. So like keep her in your prayers. It's really sad. But like already messaged me this morning and I'm like, please focus on your family. Like the business is going to be here. We're not going anywhere. But those pods, I was also able to go in and say, hey, you guys, can you just stop whatever you're doing and pray for Kim and her family. Her dad just unexpectedly died.
Wow.
Right? And so she knows not only am I praying for her, but our whole team is.
Right.
I'm also going into Kim, into our team page, into our actual team page, and I'm like, Kim just signed her eighth coach. She's two emeralds away from diamond. Can we freaking make some noise? Right? That's contributing to my team culture. I celebrate everything. You lost 3 pounds. Perfect. We're going to celebrate it. You signed your first coach. We're going to celebrate it. You got to Emerald. We're going to celebrate it. I am an Enneagram 3. I probably built this business because I strive off recognition. And in the corporate world, you get like a pendant at 5 years. So I love what we do, and I love that we have this amazing gift that we get to share with other people. So I hope that something was helpful to you guys and that you understand that leadership has its challenges, but it's really freaking fun. And diamond is obviously that stepping stone. Don't stop there, though. And if there's any advice that I can give you that I've seen this year, build fast. Build fast. I got to diamond in like 42 days and people were like, whoa, that's crazy fast. I didn't think it was. I felt like it took forever. But now I'm seeing people go diamond in like 2 weeks, a month. Like, and because here's why. When you wait, people are going to start going inactive. People are going to start crumbling. But when you have that energy and that momentum, people want to be a part of it. So you get to create that culture. You get to bring people into this. You get to then, I do, we do, me do, be a come with me girl, rinse, repeat, right? Get matching swag, do all the fun things. That's what we get to do. How, I mean, let's be real, you guys. How freaking cool is our job? Like the best thing ever, right? So think about your vision as you go home this weekend. Think about the team culture that you want to have. Think about the things that Danny and Amy and Ash and Liz and your amazing coach have said to you this weekend, when the conversations that you guys have had in those moments. And just ask yourself, why not me? Maybe it's not for the money. Maybe it's not for the six-pack abs. Maybe it's for that person who doesn't know that this opportunity exists. And you have the key to help them out of their own shit. It's a gift. Don't waste it. I know I don't know you all personally, but I believe in you and I love you and I'm always here to help you. And I pray that you're here not in just a year, but you're here in 10 years. And that you are building a legacy and a foundation for your family's future. And you're doing that for other people in years to come. Because we have a responsibility. And not only do we get to build, but we also get to break chains. And we get to rewrite our stories. And we get to help other people do the exact same thing. So be willing to pick up that heavy load of leadership and welcome people in to doing this with you because it's the greatest freaking gift. And if somebody brave didn't do it before you, you wouldn't know what's possible. So now go be brave and do it for someone else. I hope you guys have the most incredible rest of your weekend.
Right. Yes. My God. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You're so welcome, girls. I hope you guys have the best days. Please keep posting your stories because I'm like living vicariously through it as I like mop the floor. Awesome. Can you guys get up and like do a boomerang or something? Like shake or something?
You just tell me I need to stand up.
Just pretend you're at like a Tony Robbins event or you're at Summit.
Okay. I'm feeling high.
Ready? One, two, three. Woo! Got it. All right, girls.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Saturday.
Welcome. Love you. Bye.